Investigating the big issues in the west of England, Alistair McKee is next on BBC One for this week's Inside Out West.
Hello from Gloucester Road in Bristol. It's thought there are more independent shops along here than any other street in Britain.
In the programme tonight, the launch of a new local currency for Bristol. But what's the point? And will anyone want to use it?
This isn't an attack on national companies, national traders. We see it as a positive thing, a way of supporting local traders.
Also in the programme, staying safe on the internet. Are websites like Facebook threatening the stability of families with adopted children?
For birth parents who've had their children removed by the courts, they are stuck in grief. And of course they're curious. And the question is not why do they get in contact? The question is why wouldn't they?
And online bullying, an internet site accused of spreading hurtful gossip.
If you're the victim of that online abuse, it's very difficult to get recourse and to get closure because you don't know who it is that's making those particular comments.
With revealing stories from close to home, I'm Alistair McKee and this is Inside Out West. Britain, they say, is a nation of shopkeepers. But for traders on streets like this, at the moment, life is pretty tough. So would it help if we printed our own local currency to be spent in our own local shops? Dave Harvey reports on today's launch of the Bristol Pound.
The old Corn Exchange in Bristol, once the heart of the city's trade.
Well, before anyone invented credit cards or collateralised debt obligations, deals in Bristol were done simply. Cash on the old brass nail.
Now this street is home to Bristol's farmers market, people who reject global trade, preferring to sell local.
Hi there. How are you?
Good, thank you.
We're here to talk about the Bristol Pound today.
The perfect place, then, to launch Bristol's own local currency.
So, well, there'll be 1, 5, 10 and 20 pound notes. It's going to be a one-to-one parity system. So if you join the scheme, then you'll be effectively charging the same for Bristol pounds as you would as if it was in normal pounds sterling. As far as a taxman's concerned, it's the same.
These traders may sell local produce, but Kieran Mundy wants more. He wants them to join a new financial system where local is locked in.
So there's going to be a big push to get everybody involved and engaged over the next few months so that everybody can see the benefit of the independent sector. So it's there then to drive more business to people like you.
And these are the designs for the new notes. There it is. One Bristol pound. This little cockerel here, that's a security bonded hologram. When it's printed, it'll be virtually forge proof. But what goes here? That is down to the people of Bristol.
Well, we feel that it's really important for Bristol's own currency to reflect the values and the lives of the people that live here. And that's why we've opened the designs out to the public.
There must be some favourites. You're going to get the man with the bridge, aren't you, somewhere along the line?
No doubt.
Do you think you'll get a good response? There's plenty of people out there with ideas, aren't there?
To be honest, we're going to be very open-minded with what can be submitted. People are welcome to submit people for their designs, but it's by no means restricted to people alone. It can be any way that they see Bristol and feel that Bristol should be represented visually.
Will it be him or her? Maybe them. Or perhaps a big bunch of Bristol balloons. So, what should it be? Have you got an idea? If so, the Bristol Evening Post, the local paper here, is running a competition. They've got 5 weeks to choose some designs. But what's the idea? How does Bristol, having its own money, help these kind of traders?
If I was to spend a Bristol pound tenner at the market versus a normal tenner, then that tenner's going to be spent again with somebody else who uses Bristol pounds. That's going to be another independent person who lives and works in this region. And likewise, that person, and on and on and on. And that keeps that money going round and round the businesses and people of the area. That's not the case normally. It goes into a big company, goes through the company's financial system, and typically out into London and possibly into the offshore sector.
If an independent currency will work anywhere, it's here, North Street in Southville. A buzz with one-off shops and local butchers and bakers.
Oh, I don't know. It's got to be a pasty, I think. Large steak pasty, yeah.
This family-run bakery will be the first to take the new notes.
So I've got £10. Do you take Bristol pounds?
Yes, we do, yes.
Okay. To compete with the national chains, they're appealing to customers' love of all things local.
Yeah, it's better like support little man, isn't it, than it is the big chains.
Well, if you like local shops, they're going to introduce the Bristol pound. You'd only be able to use it in places like this. Do you reckon Bristolians would go for that?
I reckon around Bristol they would, yeah. Yeah, they would, don't
they? I think they realise that then the money is only going to be spent in Bristol. It's not going to go outside Bristol, you know. It's going to be spent on local suppliers, wages locally, you know. So everything is local.
And that's when things get interesting. If customers start using the new currency, the bakery will have to spend it on their own suppliers. Suppose Michelle needs a computer repaired.
Why do computers never do what you want them to do?
Well, she can't spend her Bristol tenner on a national chain. She'll have to call Dan, the local laptop man. And it's this kind of business-to-business trading that will really get the currency moving.
OK, it looks like we're all done. As you can see, it's not freezing anymore.
Of course, paying invoices in cash like this would be a pain for Michelle. If the scheme is to succeed, it'll need a 21st century system.
You can pay electronically, which is part of the unique side of Bristol's pound scheme. Other schemes, I don't think they're accepting electronic payments. So that should make things easier.
Of course, it's still early days. Only a handful of independents have signed up so far. And Dan's Bristol tenner won't fill his car up or buy him a bus ticket. But there is one way he can get around the city, Bristol fashion.
I'd like to get a ticket to the centre, please.
OK, brilliant. £1.70, please. That's
great stuff.
Single.
Do you take Bristol pounds?
I certainly do. The great Bristol pound, I do. Thanks very much. That's a tenner.
You can buy a pasty, fix a computer, take a boat trip. This Bristol currency is riding a very Bristol wave.
There's a lot of independent people out there, a lot of quirky people, a bit of hippies. They like things a bit off the wall. They like to keep it, you know, in-house and arty, that sort of thing. I think it'll do good.
But as we cruise up the harbour, all I can see is banks. Halifax, Bank of Scotland, Lloyds, the scale of sterling hits you. Can Bristol's new pound really take on the big money?
We look after over £22 billion of assets for clients across the UK. In total, we've got about 390,000 clients.
Hargreaves Lansdown. Local boys made very, very good. This Bristol firm now employs hundreds of people. And senior investment strategist Ben Yearsley is rather doubtful the new currency will actually make any difference.
So you're not going to boost spending in Bristol. You're just taking it from one, I suppose, sector or one part of the retail economy or the service economy and putting it into another part that is more locally based.
Yeah, we're trying to encourage local traders and trying to give them some advantage over the multiples. I mean, I think the multiples have got quite a lot of advantages already. You can see yourself that local traders are disappearing from the high streets, and we don't like that. I want my high street to be diverse.
But you do get all the people being employed by these national companies, and that there's always the danger that you actually, you know, if this works, you could actually see a small reduction in, I suppose, number of people employed in some of the more national chains if trade starts getting taken away.
I think actually what's more likely is that we'll help to develop a vibrant local economy. The city will thrive, and people will want to come and live here and work in national companies as well. This isn't an attack on national companies, national traders. We see it as a positive thing, a way of supporting local traders.
There have been other experiments like this before. Totnes in Devon had the first rival currency, and 18 months ago, the Stroud pound was launched. They've never got above 100 local traders involved. But Bristol has a trump card, something that'll take its pound well beyond boat trips and bakeries.
I'm going off to the council house to pay my taxes. I'm not going for donuts. I'm off to pay my taxes.
This is quite a coup for the Bristol pound, local currency with the approval of the local authority.
Right, you got your taxes?
I certainly have. Yep. Yep. Hello, Barbara.
Hello,
I've come
Jane.
To pay you my taxes, and I'm paying them in Bristol pounds.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, this is very good to see a Bristol pound at long last.
Thank you very much.
Well, we're going to enable people to actually pay their taxes in the Bristol currency, the Bristol pound, and they can pay online. They're also going to be able to use their mobile phones, and we're going to make it really as easy as possible for people to be able to actually use the Bristol pound and see how useful it is.
For the council leader, it's a little bit of history, this, a chance to send a message that Bristol is changing the way councils do business.
The money, can you hold the money up?
Of course, if taxes are paid in Bristol pounds, well, the council will have to spend them as well. Go on, Barbara, give the photographer his money.
Thank you. I think Bristol's known for its creativity and independence, and you know, it's a way of people having power with their money. Spend it local, it stays local. You spend it at Tesco's, who knows where it goes, and you know, keep the money in the community.